Nivadan. Gautri Yusri with Prasanna Venkatachariar Chaturvedi Swami Vari. Karekamalalato.
Srimate Raman Jayama. In the process of intellectual civilization of mankind, which you call as epistemology, human being has two major skills. One is the skill to conceive, second is the skill to execute. And the standard or gravity or depth of these two skills of conception and execution that differs from person to person. And that which is ephemeral, that is a transient, that which is limited by a time, limited by a concept, or demarcated by means of a depth, are limited only few members of the society. So these are all the various type of parichedas, what we call in Sanskrit, that which is can be dealt with only some area, that which can deal only with a few people or a few corners of the society, that which is time oriented, that which is benefit oriented, only within a limited guardians. So this is what we call paricheda. That which is limited with person, time, value, province, etc. So that which exceeds the beneficial components being demarcated within the barriers of time, space, person, limitation, benefit, benefit scale, etc. That is said to be sublime, sublime conception and sublime execution. So that which caters to the need of a mass, that which has perennial sever and perennial supply of benefits, and that which has a multifaceted and multidimensional execution and benefit, that which reaches all corners of the society, that which gives a deep way of probe and thinking and bestowal in the society, that is said to be sublime. Reaching all members of the society and deep-rooted inside their minds, giving a very valuable benefit and penetrating into the society for longer generations and periods. So, durability, value, mass, and gravity of the reach, everything is distinct in a sublime order. That's why we used to say two special words are coined exclusively for considering the highest or the saturated or the culminated states of thought as well as culminated state of action. Everybody they thinks and everybody they acts, but all thoughts and all acts cannot be equivalently or equipotentially gods. They are having their own variations. So the most culminated status of a person's thinking, we used to call it as a vision. Vision is also a type of imagination. It is a dream, it is a conceptualization, it is a visualization, it is a speculation, it is a program of thinking. It is also the same thought process. So whenever a person immediately thinks something out of an instinctive outburst, out of the inclination of a person's emotional and sensational proclivity, any person can start about thinking anything. So this is very thing like a lightning that has no hold, that has no charge, that has no transformation, that is no having conductivity and that is not having any productivity at all. That which has a hold, that which has a conversion, that which has a storage, that which has a potential transformation, conductivity and productivity, that is going to be a great character or a great attribute. So thought is something which lies in a very common member of the society. It is the inseparable instinct of any neurobiological sense. It is a very common happening. Any person or any human being, within the credentials of his nature being a human being, he can think. So the lowest profile of human thinking is known as thought, and the highest profile is known as vision. The lowest profile of a human execution is known as action or function. The highest profile is known as mission. So that which is in the thought level in the highest standard is known as vision. That which is in the execution in the sublime level is known as vision. So vision is the instigating spirit. Just as there is an igniter, in a gas stove there will be an igniter. A spark of the ignition, already compressed combustible gas that is operated, that is instigated, that is promulgated, that is properly attuned by means of an igniting spirit, that bombards into a bomb, or that lights into a lamp, or that furnaces into a process of metal casting, or exhibits in the form of a flame in which you can cook, depending upon the contextual barriers. Likewise, vision is the igniting spark. And if a person is having a vision in the form of an igniting spirit, then that will lead to a mission, a proper way of practical or technological implanting or implementation of the same vision to reach the goals. So now what we need for the society is not a thought or a plan, not an action or execution. What we need is we want visionaries and missionaries. Only visionaries and missionaries, they can take things out of their hearts, out of the auditorium, out of the school, out of the offices, out of the parliaments, and out of the centers of discussions and debates. Now everything is inside. Lot of people are having lot of concepts, but everything is captivated inside. They are all chained, they are all caged, they are all confined and captivated inside the minds and buildings. Everybody, they are reading about ethical, moral and spiritual principles and their implementation. What is the problem? That is inside the cage of the academic campus. That does not drive out at all. And in offices, they are discussing about professional morale and other things. In parliaments, they are debating about national issues. So everything that they carry, either lot of the good people they are carrying inside their hearts, or all of the unscrupulous elements they are carrying just in speech and within confined compounds, not being given the liberal breeze to inhale for those principles so that they can permeate in the society. That is the problem. So what we want is a vision and mission. You must not ask me whether I am a visionary or missionary. I am there to tell about the concept. As it is a global work, as it is a team work, as it is a national work, we are all the different types of people setting a fire in all of these places. Not the fire which destroys the roof of the hut, but it is a Gyanagni, it is a Tapagni, it is a Pavitragni, which is going to totally extirpate the unwanted evils of the society and installing in the essentialities that could build a future society, which is a fortune society, and which is a futuristic society with all resources in fullness, just as we have had in our ideal state before. And let us start with the tools of mission. Mission means it must have four tools. One is ideology, and second is necessity, third is leadership, fourth is participation, as per the science. And the first thing I have already told, that it is ideology. What is ideology? Taking a particular thing is known as idea. I want to achieve this thing, that is known as idea. And a totally consummate, pop-plenary, fulfilled, full-fledged, multi-faceted, multi-dimensional approach to the positive and negative factors for an idea, for accomplishment, for acquisition, for achievement and implantation, that is known as ideology. Ideology is a systematic understanding of an idea. For example, for hunger, immediately I can say, what is the only solution for poverty? Then money. And what is for hunger? Food. Yesterday, we delivered a lecture on therapies. I told that the effective therapy is money therapy. Give money to all people, immediately they will smile. Even the other therapies, they will make them laugh or to be comforted after a few weeks. So we know the solution for everything. Don't we know the solution? We know the solution. We have problems in implementation because of lack of integrity and other problems which we are going to discuss later. The first thing is, idea anybody can make. That's why great people say, ideas can be made by even fools, but ideology can be executed only by wise. I want to get money to drive away poverty. We want to increase more food productivity for eradicating hunger. We want to increase employment sources for developing youth initiatives and for lessening youth participation in unwanted activities, immoral activities and disruptive activities. So these are all the various things. Everybody knows the solution. Don't we know the solution? If we get the question paper, immediately we can pass in the examination. So we know all the answers for our questions. But what is the problem? Number one, what do you want? How much do you want? For whom you want? How much do you want? And how much you have for getting those things? What are all the hindering factors? What are all the supporting factors? What is your circumstantial and environmental cooperation and disruption? So everything is dealt in ideology. If you want to get a thing, what are all the supportive factors? What are all the clarifications of that idea? That is known as the ideology. So we have to develop an ideology which has a holistic study of all of the concepts. If you want to implant, those things are not customized. Bringing back peace in Hyderabad is different from bringing back peace at some other area. For example, Chhattisgarh, there is some problem. Jammu Kashmir, there is a problem. So there are a lot of problems on various areas. They are based on different sensations. We cannot have generalized study. There is a generalized dimension and also a customized dimension. So ideology, that gives you proper idea of how you can tackle that.